It's time for the Family Feud. Introducing the Britt family, ready for action. And the Rezzo family, on your marks. Let's start the Family Feud. With the start of Family Feud, Richard Dawson.
Gramps came in from Clayton, right? New Mexico, on their own. We never flew them in. They said they're winning, folks, and they became the champs. Here they are, right there. Clayton, it's near nowhere, right, Frank?
That's right.
How much did you win on your first trip for Fast Money?
$1,431.
Knew it without looking. I like this guy. Let me meet everybody, Clay.
Okay, Richard, this is my daughter, Shelly.
Angel.
Her husband, Ross.
Hi, Richard.
My daughter, Sandy.
Hi, Richard.
Sandy.
And her husband, Clint.
Hello.
Give them all a big welcome. Well, you got to be a rancher, aren't you?
That's right.
Rancher? You
raise cattle. That's right.
How many cattle do you have?
Quite a few.
Well, like what? 1,000?
Yeah.
1,010? Yeah, I got to figure it out. In other words, I'm talking to a cattle baron.
No, not that. We do run some cattle, yeah.
What sort?
Cattle, beef cattle that eat. Yeah, the steak sheets, you bet.
Oh, yeah, they're the goodies.
Several different breeds, but we just mix them up. Basically, they're Brangus or Hereford or Angus.
Gotcha. Well, Angus is a good old Scottish one, isn't it? We came over here.
Oh, yeah, right.
Yeah, they'll get their papers soon and then be eaten. That's the beef business for you.
That's right.
Rezzos are here. Give them a welcome. You Italian name?
Right.
Yeah, good to see you.
Welcome. Thanks, Richard.
Want to meet your family, please? Who you got here, John?
Richard, love to introduce you to my sister, Anne.
Hello,
Hi,
Anne.
Richard.
Welcome. My sister, Lisa.
Hello, Lisa.
Hi, Richard.
My sister-in-law, Anita, who has a gift for you today.
Sweet.
Hello.
Anita.
And her husband, my brother, Tom.
Right. Hello, please, Richard. Give them all a big welcome. How you doing, Don? Nice to see you. Welcome. What do you got here?
I work for the San Fernando Valley Girl Scout Council, and on behalf of the council and the Rezzo family, I'd like to give you a sample case of Girl Scout cookies.
Oh, thank you. That's lovely. You know, I do buy them every year. Do you work for a particular group? I mean, do you have a, what do they call them? Cubs?
Pack. Troop.
Thank you.
It's a troop.
I beg your
pardon.
No,
I work for the council, which is
what, is there a troop in your neighborhood? Or?
The national organization is divided into councils, and they oversee Girl Scouting in a specific jurisdiction. And so the San Fernando Valley has the San Fernando Valley Girl Scout Council.
Well, I've got to find something for the San Fernando. This way. No, that's for all the cookies. There's nothing to do with you. This is for the Girl Scout Association
well,
with my love.
Thank you so
all right?
much.
Take your lollipop, Tom, while you're here. See if you can get a $100 one. Tom got his own. I like your style.
Thank you.
We're going to play the feud. Let's go. Come on. Come on, Big John. They always come around my house, and they're always so polite. Much more so than the boys. The little girls are. That's why I always end up buying about 38 packages. From the guys, I just get a box of gum and tell them to move on. 100 people surveyed, top 5 answers on the board. You got to try and get the most popular answer, and here's the question. Name the kind of store a woman should browse through if she wants to meet a man. Yes, sir.
Grocery store.
Yeah. Two answers will beat that, Sam.
A clothing store.
Yeah. Will you play or pass? Talk it over.
We're going to play.
All right. Going to play.
All right.
Good play.
Let's go.
Yeah, I knew a girl who went to a grocery store, met Joe Cargione.
Broke
myself up here. He does vegetables on television. Kind of store, woman should browse through if she wants to meet a man.
Sporting goods store.
Sporting goods?
Yeah, good to see you.
Buddy, what do you think, sir?
Maybe she's in a hurry, a jewelry store.
Okay.
Good.
Well, they cut out the rubbish. A jewelry store. Now, she takes him to a jewelry store, Ross. I'm ashamed that you don't know that.
Hello.
What do you think? What sort of store should a woman browse through if she wants to meet a man?
A shoe store.
Okay. Shoe store? No. Let's try. Clint, nice to see you. Get that lollipop now, Clint. Make me proud of you.
Oh.
Well, no, you want that because that means you won the last one, remember?
Right. That's right. Yes, sir. Yeah.
What store we got?
Shoe store.
You just hand that over here. Probably where you heard it.
Hat store.
Hat store. Okay. Well, look. In New Mexico, Texas, there are lots of hat stores, and that's where you'd see guys doing it. Pardon?
A lot of dogs.
Get out of here. Hat store? No. $83.200
Hardware store.
We're looking for a store. We'll browse through there, and going to be the man.
How about a hardware store?
All right. Let's see. All right. You get the money if it's there, John. If not, give it to Big Sam. Hardware? Yeah. Four. And a bookstore. Yeah. I should take, but I was just kidding about the Boy Scouts. They're just as polite as a girl. You're not as cute, but you are just as polite. We'll be back right after.
Ringling Ravers. Pika.
Rezzo's got the money, $83. Big Sam, nothing. Come on, Shelley.
Thank you.
100 people surveyed, top 8 answers on the board. Here's the question. Name an animal that makes a totally unmistakable sound.
A lion.
A lion. 4 answers will beat it.
A cow.
A cow. Play or pass?
We're
going to play, my love. All right. Good.
Sorry.
It's all right. An animal that makes a totally unmistakable sound, right?
A dog.
A dog. He ain't a dog.
How about a cat?
Okay, a pussy cat.
What a way, sir.
Yeah. Done, eh?
Elephant.
Elephant, right. Elephant. Yeah! It just makes me smile. That's all. Big Sam, an animal, makes a totally unmistakable sound.
How about a horse?
I think so. Let's see. Any about 100 people say a horse? They did not. Well, I think I'd recognize it. Wouldn't you?
I think I would.
Shelly?
Chicken.
Chicken!
Good answer.
Colonel's got eggs.
Yes.
Ross.
Got to be a duck.
Uh-huh.
Come on, yes.
Who walks and talks like a duck's probably a duck. Is there a duck there? There ain't. $4, 3 unrevealed answers. Here we go.
Monkey or a hyena?
Hyena.
Animal that makes a totally unmistakable sound.
What a laughing hyena.
Okay. Hyena's there, you get it all. If not, Big Sam's on the board. Hyena? Is that a horse? We'll be back.
Really?
It's all over there. 147. Nothing for my champs yet. Ross, I need you up here. Lisa. How you doing? You sit up? 100 people surveyed, top six answers on the board. Here is the question. Name a U.S. city with a reputation for being a tough place.
Chicago.
Chicago, toddling town. One answer will be
New York.
The Big Apple, New York. You got it.
We'll play, Richard.
Well done. Sweet Anita. U.S. city with a reputation for being a tough place.
Detroit.
Uh-huh. Motown, Detroit. Yeah. Marvin.
Dallas.
Dallas? Oh. They just beat you financially down there, I think. Sure.
Nothing against the city, but how about Philadelphia?
Yeah, we're not against any of these cities. Philly? Right.
How about Hollywood?
Hollywood, all right.
Oh, that's good.
Hollywood! Oh, okay. Lisa?
I'm going to say Los Angeles.
Well, that's Hollywood, right?
Oh,
yeah.
Hollywood.
No, that'd be the same.
Okay. How about San Francisco?
Okay. If it's there, all right. If not, third strike. San Francisco!
Miami?
Boy, what a good. If it's there, you got it at an enormous lead. Miami! Not that. $93. Come on, Big Sam. Got to get into this game now, champ. We want a U.S. city with a reputation for being a tough place.
Pittsburgh.
Cleveland. All right. Was there, you get it. If not, a great big lead. Cleveland? Yeah, I don't know. I thought Miami would be there. Four. Newark, you know, they did have a lot of riots there, but I didn't think it held over being tough, did it? Although I certainly had a marvelous time being roughed up in San Francisco. 240, nothing, let's go! They not only mug you up there, they tell you what to dress, what to wear. 100 people surveyed, top six answers on the board. Here's the question. Name something people do at the kitchen table.
Eat.
They eat, said Zen. Sounds like a good eight. Eat. Play a pass. All right. La-la. Something people do at the kitchen table, Cliff.
They visit.
Okay. Top. They visit. Yeah.
Play cards.
They do. Play cards? You got it, Sam. I like that.
Read the newspaper.
Another goodie. They read. Yeah. Now we're in the game. Right.
Family discussion or meeting?
That'd be talk, I think, would it not? Thank you.
It's all right. I'm blank.
So just look at it. Something people do. At the kitchen table. Give me an answer, okay? Give you 3 seconds. Give me an answer.
How about write letters?
Love that. Want to write a letter? Yes. Come on, Kurt.
Watch television.
Little watching TV. Show us. Not there. Good answer, Clint. Sam, let's do it right now. Something people do at the kitchen table. Mm-hmm. 3 seconds, Sam. Mm-hmm. Okay. Right now, you get the $96. Give me number five.
Say grace.
Okay.
Say grace gets you it all. If not, you're in the game. Say grace! Oh. 36 to nothing. Here we go. Come on. Don Clint, shake hands then. Mark Clint, you got to get on the board. 400 points wins it. Dollar value's doubled. 100 people surveyed. Top five answers on the board. Here's the question. Name a spice you can buy either whole or ground up.
Tom. Pepper.
Pepper. Play or pass?
Okay, we're going to play.
Okay. spice you can buy either whole or ground up.
Bay leaves.
Bay leaves. No. And?
Oregano.
Oregano.
Ooh.
What spice is not there?
Basil.
Basil. No. But take a look. We got good news and bad news. The good news is a lot of answers can get you in the game. The bad news, if you don't get it, they're the champs.
Mm-hmm. Let's go.
Spice you can buy either whole or ground up.
Garlic.
Garlic.
Garlic. Garlic. Garlic.
Okay, sir. Is it there? Garlic. Number two. Cloves. Three. Gentlemen, five. Nutmeg. 336 to 88. Here we go, boys. Big Sam, let's go. Come on. Wish each other luck now. Dollar values are tripled. 100 people surveyed. Top three answers on the board. Here's the question. Name the first thing you take off after work.
Yep. Your shoes.
Shoes, said Sam.
We're going to play.
We're going to play. I believed you the first time, Big Sam. I'm going to read it once. I get to you. You got 3 seconds to answer it. Only two answers left. Remember how you won this, now. Remember the family? You struck out and you were gone. Here you go. Name the first thing you take off after work. 3 seconds.
Coat. Left.
Coat. 3 seconds, Ross.
Your hat.
Hat there. Keep the title. Is it enough?
No.
All right. Hat. No.
Your tie. Your tie.
Your tie. Keep the game going. Tie. Yeah. We got 370 to 336 and Billy. Dollar values again are tripled. 100 people surveyed. Top three answers on the board. Here is the question. Name something you wind up.
Yeah.
We'll play. Same thing. We'll read it. 3 seconds. Won't repeat it. Name something you wind up. 3 seconds.
Children's right. Toys.
You need a specific... Something?
Toys.
Specific toy. Give me a toy.
The top.
Don't just say toys. Give me a toy. What toy?
The top.
A top. Okay. A top. Well done. Yay! 3 seconds.
How about a batter winds up?
A batter. 3 seconds, Clint.
Duck.
Duck. No. Big Sam, 3 seconds. Chance for you to get your title. Right now, you can be the champ. Name something you wind up. What do you think it is?
Music box.
Sounds like a goodie. If it's there, you are the champs. If not, you keep the title. Music box. We're late because I went to 6 questions, so I gotta say goodbye to you quickly. We got $370 plus $1,431. I hope you like it. You're good people, and I like you. Thank you for being here, really. And you're gorgeous. I hope you had a nice week. Okay. Come on, let's go. Who's first? All right. And go to your room. And Anita, play for the money right after we watch this.
Up.
15 seconds, please. Good luck.
Thank you.
Step just a little way, just a little this way, so that's
good.
Name something people have printed on their stationery.
Their name?
A foreign money.
Vessel.
A fruit used in making daiquiris.
Strawberries.
Something found in a schoolroom.
A chalkboard.
The age when kids get braces.
16.
What foreign money did you say?
Peso.
Peso.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, but she
Peso.
Did it so well. Yes, yeah, you know, listen, say it again because it sounded great.
Peso.
I'm sure that's correct. It sounds Mexican Spanish to me. With just a dash of German thrown in. Peso.
For good measure.
Something people have printed on the stationery. You said their name. Survey said. Foreign money. Peso. Say it again for me.
Peso?
I love it. Survey!
Yeah.
Cookies and making daiquiris, strawberries for everybody. Survey said. Oh, found in the schoolroom, you said. Chalkboard survey said. Oh, wow. England kids get braces, you said. 16, survey said. Okay, that's a great score.
Thank you.
Oh, stand right next to John, please, and we're looking for sweet Anne. 51 points, that's all we need.
Okay.
Wish you luck, please remind everyone the great answers that Anita gave us in 20 seconds on the clock, please. Name something people have printed on their stationery.
Their initials.
A foreign money.
A franc.
A fruit used in making daiquiris.
Strawberry.
Try again.
Peach.
Something found in a schoolroom.
Desks.
The age when kids get braces.
13.
Turn around. People have printed on their stationery. Number one answer was name. You said initials. Survey said. Wendy, fall. Foreign money. Peso or peso was number one. You said franc. I said Sinatra. Survey said. Wendy, two. Fruit used in making daiquiris. Strawberries, number one. You said peaches. Worth 5 points, $5,000. Survey said. Zero. Something found in the schoolroom. You said desk. 5 points, 5,000. Survey said. School's out.
Desk is number one. Kids get braces at 12.
Say it for me one more time.
Pesos.
We see you here on the Feud. Bye bye.
Some departing contestants receive the Mr. Coffee Altronic System, Space Age technology for the most perfect cup of coffee on this planet or any other. Now, Diet 7-Up has 100% NutraSweet and no saccharin. Diet 7-Up may be the best diet soft drink ever. Ramen Fried, America's best-selling Oriental noodles and ramen soup are ready to eat, treat in a cup. Just add water, no preservatives, both from Samoa Foods. Introducing new Vaseline Lip Therapy. It creates a moisture barrier that locks out weather, so with regular use, you may never get chapped lips again. This is Gene Wood speaking for Family Feud, a Mark Goodson television production.